Hello guys, and welcome to Mastery Tutoring. I'm your tutor Kara from Mastery Tutoring. Today we're going to be doing a question from a 2017 IEB final exam, which is question 5. Question 5, we are given that we're given that f of x is equals to x minus 3 squared. Now number 1, it says that determine f of prime x from first principle. So let's remember one thing. The formula for from first principle looks like this: f of prime x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of f of x plus h minus f of x. Everything divided by h. Now this is the formula from first principle. Okay, so now let's simplify this one into a quadratic function form. So this x minus 3 squared is the same as x minus 3 multiplied by x minus 3. Therefore, this is going to be, so now we FOIL this. I believe you all know how to FOIL, but let me just simplify it for you. So we have, I'm going to take this, multiply it with that, and then you take it again, you multiply it with that. Now let's do that part. So we're going to give, you're going to have x times x is going to be x squared, and then x times minus 3 is going to be minus 3x. We did the first part. Going to the second part, we take this guy, we multiply with that, and then we take this one and multiply with that. And then what do we get? We might get minus x plus 9. Awesome. Moving to the next step now. So this is equal to f of prime x. We haven't started with the differentiation. We haven't. So now when we simplify this further, you get x squared minus 6x plus 9. Now we apply that formula now. We can apply this on that formula. So basically what this means is that wherever there's x, you substitute x plus h. Just like here, there's x squared, it's going to be x plus h squared minus 6 x plus h. That's how it goes. Here we're not going to put x plus h because there's no x. Let's go f prime x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of x plus h squared. Remember, where there's x, we substitute x plus h. So here it's x plus h squared minus 6 minus 6 minus 6 x plus h plus 9. This is the first part. And then now we also have this one minus. Now because it says minus f of x, it means we're copying it as it is. We're not changing anything. It's going to be minus x squared minus 6 x plus 9. So we divide this whole thing by 8. F of prime x is equals to the limit as h approaches 0 of what? So we're going to have to simplify this further. We're going to have to FOIL it. You basically apply the same thing that I did here. You're going to first expand it into two brackets, so two identical brackets, and then from there you FOIL it just like we did up there. So I'm going to skip this step. I'm not going to show when you're foiling and everything. I'm quite sure that if you can follow these steps, you'll definitely get to the same stage as what I'm going to get here. So this is going to be x squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus, now we multiply this one into, this becomes 6x minus 6h plus 9. Multiply this one in there, it gives us minus x squared minus 6x minus, so excuse me, this one's going to be plus 6x, this one's going to be minus 9. Let me just confirm, minus x squared plus 6x minus 9, yes. Yeah. Minus 6x minus 6h plus 9. I'm just confirming if I didn't make any mistake, because you know, we humans, we make mistakes. Okay, we divide the whole thing by h. Now f prime x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of what? Now, when we're at this point now, we're going to take out these brackets. So we're going to be left with x squared plus 2xh plus h squared minus 6x minus 6h plus 9 minus x squared plus 6x minus 9. Then we divide the whole numerator by h. F of prime x is equal to the limit as h approaches 0. Here we're going to look for, we're going to group like terms. And then when we look at this one is, we can be grouped with that. But now the difference is this one is negative and this one is positive. Therefore, they're going to sum up to a 0. Moving right along. Is there anything like 2xh, like xh here? There's nothing like xh, therefore it's not going anywhere. When you check, is there anything like h squared here? There's nothing, only this one here. It's gonna stay. Is there anything like 6x, x with a constant, with a coefficient? So there's this one here which is minus 6. There's also this one that is positive. They sum up to 0. We check again. Is there anything with h? No h squared, just h. There's only this one here. Anything which is just a constant, yes, we have a positive 9 there and a negative 9 there. So they sum up to a 0. Now let's write what's remaining. So everything that I've circled is gone. Rather, let me just put this to show that these ones are gone. They're no longer with us. They're dead. And then now what we're left with? We're left with 2xh. H squared, and then we also left with minus 6h, and then the whole thing is divided by h. Okay, now f of prime x is given by the limit as h approaches 0. Now here in the numerator we can factor out h, so we have h of 2x. Now when you take out h, you're going to be left with 2x plus, you take out h there, you're going to be left with h minus, you take out h, you're going to be left with 6. Divide the whole thing by h. Now this is a division, so this guy and that one, they're going to cancel out, they're going to divide each other. H over h gives us, now we're left with f of this. Okay, let me just say this is equal to the limit as h approaches 0 of 2x plus h minus 6. Now we're going to substitute where there's h, we put a 0. So here we're going to substitute a 0. And when you do that, you'll be left with 2x plus 0 minus 6. And then we go to the final answer, which is just 2x minus 6. Here is the derivative of the given function. Yeah, it was very long, but I'm glad that we were able to get to the final answer, and I don't think I lost anyone along the way. But if I did, you know, feel free to let me know. You know, comment down below and I'll get back to you. If there's anything that you don't understand, or maybe I just rushed through, let me know. And then let's look at, if you like, you can actually confirm this to see if it gave you the correct, because it's easy to make mistakes, you know. So now proof, just checking yourself, right? You don't have to do this, by the way, so check. So given that f of x is equal to x minus 3 squared, which later became x squared minus 6x plus 9. Now, when you apply the other method, basically what the other method says is, let me walk you through it quickly. It says that if you have a d of d x to the power of n, this becomes, so the n comes down. So n comes down here. You have n multiplied by x to the power of n minus 1. So this is basically what you're applying. So we're going to apply the same thing here. And then let's see what we get. Now when you take this 2 and bring it down, you're going to have 2 x to the power of 2 minus 1 minus 6. Now because it's 1, when it comes down, let me just bring it down, times 1 multiplied by x to the power of 1 minus 1 plus, now the 9, because there's no a variable next to 9, it's a constant, it becomes a 0. X is equal to, now this is going to be 2 to the power of, 2 minus 1 is 1, so just going to be 1 there, minus 6 times 1 is 6, 1 times 1 is x to the power of 0, x to the power of 0, where this whole thing becomes 2x minus 6. Any number to the power of 0 is equal to 1. So now we've proven that these two are equal. As you can see, this one and this two, they are equal. So we've proven ourselves, we checked ourselves, you know. Remember guys, the second part, this part that I've written in red, it's not part of the equation. Let's move on to the next part of the equation, right? So it says determine the gradient of f at x equals to negative 3. So that is number 2. So we're determining the gradient at x is equals to minus 3. We'll double check if I copied this right. Don't want to be making mistakes. So it's x minus 3, okay. Right, so now this becomes, so we already have this. So f of prime is equal to 2x minus 6. Now to find the gradient at this point, we just substitute the value of 3 in this expression. Remember, you don't substitute it at the original function, no. Substituted at this one, the first derivative, because it's the gradient. If you can revisit your calculus textbook, they'll tell you that this is your gradient occurs at the when you get the first derivative. So now when you substitute now the value of minus 3 for this x, we get 2 times negative 3 minus 6, and then the whole thing becomes minus 12. Just a second. So this is equal to minus six. Therefore, f of prime that minus 3 becomes minus 12. So that is our slope or the gradient. at x is equal to negative 3. Thank you guys for joining me. Remember, if there's anything that you don't understand or you missed out, let me know. Just go to our website or leave a comment here.